So I am Priyanka Shinde, working as a digital strategist. So first of all, I would like to thank you for joining this session and giving a great response for our previous webinars and virtual meetups. Many of you have attended our previous webinars and events. So once again, we would like to thank you all for giving such a great response for each and every webinar and meetup that we are organizing. So today's webinar is on building recommendation system using Azure Machine Learning. So this webinar is hosted by Azure Community and Synergetics and sponsored by Microsoft. So before we move forward, I would like to tell you about this Azure Python webinar series. So we have took so many initiatives about in this COVID situation. So in this situation, we have already organized many meetup series. For example, we have already we are going to complete our AI meetup series, then DP webinar series, and this is our one more webinar series which is on Azure and Python. So this is about Azure Python workshop and Python webinar. So I will tell you more about this afterwards. So before moving forward, I would like to tell you about Azure Tech Community. So we have started this community for a few months back, and under this community we have hosted many events and meetups, and all the COVID in this COVID situation we have hosted multiple events, webinars under this community. And if anyone wants to join this community, they are welcome. So if you are interested in any Azure related technology, we are hosting different tech events in this community. So you just need to follow our community on Meetup, visit Meetup and search for Azure Tech Community, and then you can follow us on there. So you can get direct updates about our upcoming events and webinars through Meetup. So before we start our session, there is a code of conduct. You can't click the images of ongoing presentation which is provided by which is conducted by our speaker. Also, you can't record the session. These are some small etiquettes we need to follow. About today's agenda, which is connect to an Azure Machine Learning Service Workplace. So machine learning is very important role plays when we want to develop a decision making system who makes a direct decision for us. So we will see in today's session how Azure Machine Learning helps in these situations while building applications. So our speaker for today's meetup is today's webinar is Mr. Chandrasekhar Deshpande. So I would like to introduce him. Maybe many of you have already attended his previous webinars, but I would like to give a small introduction about him. So Chandrasekhar is a data all-rounder with unique blend of experience in multitude of data-related technologies. He has more than 30 plus years of experience in this technological industry. He is a Microsoft certified trainer and specialized in technologies like big data, analytics, machine learning, Azure, Hadoop, and many more. He has worked with various Fortune companies like Accenture, Infosys, Microsoft, L&T, Intel, and many more company. And he has trained n number of employees from this company on the different technologies. So my words are very less to describe his great experience and work in this industry. So he is going to solve your each and every doubt about the Azure Machine Learning. So now I'll tell you about our Azure Python series. So we took this initiative and we are going to host two workshops and two webinars in Azure Python live workshop and webinar series. So there are two webinars. So today is the first webinar and second webinar is on 25th June. And there are two workshops. One workshop is on 28th June and second one is 27th June. So this workshop is a whole day training, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. and we are taking a limited entries for this workshop because this is a training which we are going to give you. So if you haven't registered for this workshop, please register as soon as possible, because for example we received a 20 registrations from a one single company, then we are going to only give 10 people who has registered first. So we will allow only 10 people from the from one company to attend this workshop. So this workshop is very helpful and insightful and informative for you. So this is a whole day live training workshop. So please register as soon as possible. So as I told you, we have also started a meetup series which is on AI, which is AI on Azure meetup virtual meetup series. So under this series, we have already hosted four webinars and there only one webinar is left, which is on 18th June next Thursday. So if you want to join this webinars and but you are worried about our previous webinar, just visit our YouTube channel and there you will get our previous webinars. So you attend them and then you can attend this last fourth webinar, which is on AI solutions with Azure natural language processing. As I told you, we have started one more series which is on BP. Webinars on DP certification. So we have already done two webinars, which is on DP 200 certification and DP 201 certification. So this is the third and last webinar from this series. So this is a DP 100 designing and implementing a data science solution on Azure. So this webinar is going to webinar is conducted on 19 June 2020. So if you haven't registered for this webinar, you need to register, and for the previous two webinars you need to visit our YouTube channel so you can cope up for third webinar. So this is an interesting announcement for all of you. Microsoft is going to sponsor a laptop, Microsoft Surface Go, for one lucky winner who is going to complete their certification in between 19th May to 26th June. So this we just got updated about this, so that is why the date hasn't changed yet. So they have extended this date to 26th June. So if you complete your certification in between 19th May to 26th June, you will win a chance to you can win a Microsoft Surface Go. So there are four simple steps you need to follow. You just need to register with our company's page, this data and AI campaign page, and then you need to complete your certification, data or AI certification, which includes DP 200, DP 201, DP 100 and AI 100 certification. And once you complete your certification, you need to post your certification or badge on LinkedIn and you need to tag Microsoft as well as our company Synergetics, and then you will stand a chance to win a Microsoft Surface Go. So under this campaign, we are giving you discount on training. So if you go outside, you will get a certification with the training which cost you almost more than 35,000. So we are already giving you a discount if you come to us other way. So you will get a training for 17,500. But if you enroll under this campaign, you will get this package in only 15,000. Also, you will if you have any queries and you don't know how to give an exam just by sitting home, or complications or doubts with the certifications or the content of the course, then we are providing a free live mentoring sessions. You just need to come to us, or you can mail me your doubts, then we will schedule your live mentoring session with best trainers from the industry, and they will guide you about this. So also we are giving a 10% discount on exam voucher. For example, if you want to prepare for a certification by yourself, or then also and you just need an exam voucher, then we are giving 10% discount on exam voucher as well. For more batches and everything you want to know, then visit our training calendar. So Master with Microsoft Azure Certification Virtual Training. So these are the four main reasons you need to do certification. So basically we are still sitting at home and we are still working from home. So this is the best time to upgrade ourselves, upgrade our certification. So we are giving you some opportunities by how you can complete your certification just by sitting at home. So we took this small initiative. We are providing a live sessions and trainings, as well as we have already conducted a webinar on how you can take a exam just by sitting at home. So if you need this webinar, the content of from this webinar is not disclosable for everyone. So if you want to see this webinar, we have already posted on YouTube, but you need to first mail me. After that, we will give you access for this webinar, so you can watch this webinar, and you will get to know how you can complete your certification and how you can attend an exam just by sitting at your home. So this is the calendar, different from the data and AI campaign. So this is a this calendar includes AZ certifications as well. So if you you can see this calendar on our website as well. And in this package, we are giving live training plus MOC plus exam voucher only in 17,500. So if you have any doubt regarding this, you can directly contact me or our concerned person for this trainings is Ms. Shilpa Award. So we are giving this discount only till 15 June. So you can contact us. Here we have shared our concerned person's mail ID and mobile number. You can directly contact her and give our give my reference, or tell her that you have attended this webinar or meetup, and from there you get this information about this discount, and she will help you. So once again, thank you very much for joining today's session, and I hope you will like our this Python webinar and workshop series. So now Chandrashekhar sir, you can take it from here.
Thanks Priyanka, and welcome all of you. This is a next series on machine learning. I got an opportunity to interact with all of you earlier also, so I'm really happy to interact you again. The topic for today is how can you design ML pipeline for recommendation engine. So here I will quickly first of all introduce to you what is ML service, what is ML designer. Okay, and then we will use ML Designer to create a recommendation engine pipeline. Okay, so let me share my screen. Just a minute. Okay, first of all, would like to ask all of you whether I am not able, whether my audio is not reaching to somebody, and whether my screen, shared screen, is not reaching to somebody. Okay, you can post a message, okay, so that I will come to know that I am really reaching to all of you. Able to, huh? That, thanks. Huh. Okay. So friends, as far as ML machine learning is concerned, I need not have to, you know, introduce machine learning at this juncture. Everybody here is aware what exactly it is. There are different tools we are using to design ML. So maybe some of you have used the Databricks, or some of you might have used ML Workbench, which was introduced some 3 years back by Microsoft. Now recently, since 2 years, they have introduced something called as a ML service. Okay, I am taking you quickly to the portal. Okay, and here ML service option is available. So specifically in here, I can type ML service. Machine learning. So it is available. This is a managed service, okay, which is being offered by Azure, okay, and I can create ML machine learning managed service from here. What it does actually, it creates a workspace. Thereby, it creates a workspace, okay. But let me, before I start creating the workspace, let me just quickly cover some of the basics, and then we will move to create the workspace, and thereby we will see how can, by using designer, we can make our pipeline. Okay, so here you observe, machine learning is a platform for ML workloads, or wherever we want to do prediction, there we use machine learning. So there are different algorithms available in machine learning. Okay, and these machine learning algorithms are pre-written. These algorithms are written by statisticians and mathematicians. Okay, so we, in case if we are not from the background of analytics or mathematics, nothing to worry about. These algorithms are readily given to us. What is essential for us to know, which algorithm to use in which scenario. And once we come to know about this, then we need to know, means how can we use that algorithm. Say, how can we write a data pipeline, ML pipeline, specifically in Python or in Scala or in Java or in R. Multiple languages are available to do the same thing. Okay, and then we have to use a specific platform. So popular platforms are like Databricks is there, or Spark ML, Spark Engine is also there. Okay, Databricks is one of the platform where end-to-end enterprise development can be done. Okay, and similar kind of platform is offered by Azure. Okay, which has many features, and which is really which has very small learning curve compared to all other platforms. So Azure machine learning scalable. Whenever we talk about machine learning on Azure, it harnesses power of cloud computing. So it is highly scalable, on-demand compute. Okay, it can connect to variety of the data sources, Azure data sources, as well as the data sources which are beyond Azure, which are non-Azure. We can orchestrate the ML workflow also. So in order to orchestrate ML workflow, or in order to deal with the DevOps in ML, we do not call it as a DevOps, now we call it as a ML Ops. Machine learning ops. So there is an arrangement of pipeline, something called, so something is called as a pipeline. Okay, so remember here, normal DevOps does not work for machine learning. There is something called as a pipeline. Okay, pipeline can form a building for a building block for normal DevOps. So there can be a normal DevOps also, but these pipelines ML pipeline specifically form building blocks for normal DevOps. So here ML pipelines we have to deal with, okay, and these pipelines, they can basically orchestrate overall machine learning stages and steps. Model is to be created, that model is to be registered with machine learning services, and once we register it with machine learning services, then that model we can use to deploy on the production environment. So there can be a production environment which is highly scalable as well as can be made quickly ready. Okay, so Azure Kubernetes services are there where we can do the deployment of a model, and that model then becomes productive. It can be used in real-time analysis, it can be used for even batch processing. In real-time analytics, that model takes a web service as an input, does the prediction and returns the prediction back to the user. Okay, in batch processing, okay, user data is to be given to the model. It applies its prediction on every record of the input data and creates the responses, and then writes those responses into some data sync. So end-to-end solution we are getting here on Azure Machine Learning. And one more point I would like to bring to everybody's notice, that in case if you are from the Databricks background, okay, this end-to-end development you can do on Azure Databricks, and the things which are not possible on Azure Databricks, specifically for publishing the model, okay, we can use Azure Machine Learning services into Azure Databricks to do to complete the production pipeline. Okay, so Azure Machine Learning services and Azure Databricks also can go hand in hand. Okay, you can create a say model in Azure Databricks, and you can submit that model for Azure Machine Learning services for the for registration as well as for publishing. Azure Machine Learning workspace we have to create. This is a managed service, and basically here you get some storage of space where your business assets go. Whatever be the pipeline you design, whatever be the notebooks you design, okay, so all these things go into the workspace. So in the workspace you get the compute to run your code, you get the notebooks there, you get a template of the pipeline that you have designed. Their data sets are maintained, there are different experiments are maintained. Experiments are nothing but the pipeline runs. Every run of the pipeline is maintained there, how much time that run has taken, what are all responses of that run, all those things are recorded there, and different models are also registered. So here we have to create something called as a workspace first. Okay, these are some additional supportive services are created. Whenever you are creating the workspace, it has to create a storage account to hold all these business assets there. Okay, application insight. Application insight is to monitor the micro level working of your application. Every step you can monitor, okay, that you can make possible through application insight. Key vault is there to hold your secrets. Virtual machines it has to create internally as a part of the compute, okay, because whenever you want to run your code, that code gets executed on the virtual machine. So other services are also created. So this is a managed service, which is nothing but a collection of multiple other services. I will not maximize this screen, so just have a look at it, whether I can increase its size. Yes, I can increase its size. Okay, so whenever we are creating Azure Machine Learning service, okay, we do get a screen something like this. So now what I do, I first of all go to portal to create Azure Machine Learning service. In the meantime, let me check whether I have got any message. Yes. Okay, so here I am creating a new resource group. Maybe meetup 11 June. Okay, workspace name I am giving. Okay, so meetup ML service. Okay, some name I have given. I go with Southeast Asia Workspace Edition. Now I have to, you know, use the designer tool. So I have to go with Enterprise Edition, because designer tool I will not get in Basic Edition. So I have to go to Enterprise. I have to choose for Enterprise Edition. I am clicking on Review plus Create. Okay, and now maybe in next 5 minutes it will create this workspace. Again, I repeat, this workspace is nothing but collection of many resources, including the storage. What are all business assets I do create? All those business assets go into the storage, and besides that, there will be the network and other kind of other kind of services it will create. It has to create a virtual machine also. Okay, as of now, validation is passed. I'm clicking on create. Virtual machine it will create whenever I ask it to create the compute. Now there are three types of computes. I will tell you what are all there, why there are three types of computes, and in which scenario which compute to choose. That also I will quickly describe to you. Okay, so whenever this service will be up and ready, okay, this service is a separate portal. So this kind of web page do I see when I open the portal? Okay, here are all the options, and here are different direct choices available, shortcuts available. Okay, then I will start with the designer, and on that designer then we will try to create some kind of pipeline. Okay, so it is still under development, deployment. Let it get deployed. There are three things possible here through ML service. One is a designer, second is a ML service, and third is the auto ML, automated ML. Now let me quickly make the differences among these three. First of all, let us talk about the designer. Now, in this designer is a UI kind of tool. It is like a drag and drop, do the configuration and test your pipeline. So whenever you want to quickly create ML pipeline, okay, and test it, you have to submit test data, and you have to just check whether what is the performance of that, okay, and you have to, if it is, it's a performance is good, if you want to deploy it quickly, okay, there you can go with a designer tool. Designer tool does not need any language background. Okay, although in case if you have language background, it is helpful, but otherwise, okay, hardly you need to write some say Python code there or some scripting code there. Most of the part of designer tool is like drag and drop. There may be some transformations which are many transformation options are already given, but there may be some transformations which are to be customized. There are only some Python code or R code you may have to write, but otherwise, okay, most of the part of designer tool you don't have to have any scripting background. Okay, now if you want to customize whole pipeline, okay, for many models. Now whenever you are talking about machine learning, okay, what happens is designer will not allow you to, you know, try with more than two models. Designer allows you to try with one model only. Okay, but if you want to try with multiple models, you can go with ML service, where you have to write a Python code, you have to give different sets of hyperparameters to it, you can use a different kinds of algorithms, and you can create a multiple models. Okay, and if you want to do the comparison between these different models with respect to the performance, that is also possible. Okay, but all these things you have to do in the Python. Okay, Python or whatever be the language you choose. Okay, I mostly work with it using Python, that's why. Okay, but otherwise you can use a Scala, you can use R, so multiple languages are available there. Now my instance of ML service is up and ready. I am clicking on launch now. Okay, and see here, it has opened it in the separate portal. Okay, and here is the same kind of screen. Now I will begin with a. So here, if you go through this list, this is a menu. Okay, from here you can open the netbook. From here you can open the designer. If you open the notebook, then you will have to write the Python code. Okay, if you go to the designer, then it is a drag and drop. What is this automated ML? Now let me tell you. Okay, in notebook, you have to decide which model to create to do the comparison. In automated ML, what happens is your ML service itself chooses the appropriate algorithm. Okay, try different hyperparameters over there, and then creates n number of models. How many models should it create? That count you can give. So if you are asking it to create 25 models, it will create 25 different models, and it will, you know, assess the performance of each and every model. Everything will happen automatically. So it will assess the performance of each model, and the best performing model it will choose, and that model then we can, you know, ask it to go ahead to do the deployment on the production environment. Okay, so many things are automated here, and there then your time of, you know, manually doing all these things can be saved. So automated ML is also a good option. I will go to the designer. Okay, acha, other options let me quickly mention here. Data set, experiments, pipelines, models, endpoints, compute, data stores, data labeling. So compute first of all, quickly. Okay, so compute instance, compute cluster, inference cluster. Okay, so compute instance is whenever you want to try your Python commands through the notebook, you need a compute instance. So every Python command that you are submitting through the notebook will be executed on this compute instance. So whenever you are doing some interactive exploration, okay, there you can go with a compute instance. Say interactive exploration means that the first command is given, the response of the first command is assessed, and then you are giving the second command. There then you can go with a compute instance. Compute cluster, now this designer will use a compute cluster. Okay, so there we will create one cluster, okay, of one node or multiple nodes. Okay, and whatever be the actions we will add into the designer, those actions will be executed on the compute cluster. So before I go to the designer, I can create one compute cluster from here. Okay, so I'm clicking on create a new training cluster. Okay, here it is asking me some name to this cluster. So I may be naming it as a default cluster. Okay, Southeast Asia, CPU or GPU, that I can choose from here. Okay, GPU, graphics processing unit, specifically when you go for cognitive services, there you have to go with a graphics processing unit. CPU is enough for me. Okay, virtual machines, as of now, I will go with a dedicated. Okay, here is a long list of the machines you can choose. Depending on the workload you have to do, you have to process here. Okay, you can choose, okay, which machine you can go with, or you need to go with. Okay, so it is a very long list of available machines. Now my subscription does not have available quota for this, but otherwise those machines are also, F series machines, M series machines are also available to add here to form the cluster of. Okay, so I just choose this DS3 V2. Okay, I don't need high performing machine or machine with high infrastructure. Minimum number of nodes, I go with one. Maximum number of nodes, I can go with two. So two nodes are sufficient. Idle seconds before scale down, I just mentioned 20 minutes. In case if there is no request submitted to this cluster for 20 minutes, okay, it will start, you know, shutting down this cluster. Okay, so here I am creating one cluster for running my designer pipeline, and it will take next maybe a couple of minutes to get the cluster ready. Okay, in the meantime, let me just quickly explain you the rest of the things. Okay, now for what inference cluster is used? Okay, this will be for running my designer. This will be for compute instances for running my Python commands. Okay, inference cluster basically is for testing my application on the production, I mean to say production like environment. Okay, so I can either have a production like environment here, or I can have actual production environment here. Okay, so this is basically a Kubernetes services or container say instances, ACI or AKS like cluster I can create here, which will work at a production level. Okay, so it is now creating the first node, and it will always keep one node alive there, so which it will help me to quickly run my code. Okay, now here it is. Whenever I create a pipeline, I have to mention I run that pipeline, okay, for the purpose of testing. Okay, so every of its run is called as a experiment. Every of its run is called as an experiment. After I run the pipeline, okay, then perhaps multiple such pipelines creating multiple such models I execute, and then I get one highly performing model, which then I register with the Azure ML service. I can see that registered model here. Okay, so model is registered. If it is a Python, it is always, you know, serialized into pickle file. Okay, so that model exists here in terms of the pickle file, and anybody, okay, can pick up that model from this registered set of models, okay, and can publish it. Okay, now whenever we publish it, so my cluster is up and ready. Whenever we publish it, okay, then it becomes ready to accept a web services. Okay, so now I am going to the designer, and here then I will create one pre-built pipeline or new pipeline. I will create here. So this is, let me click here. New pipeline. So I have to name this pipeline. So what I will be doing here is, I will be using some recommendation. I will be designing recommendation pipeline. I am naming it as a recommendation, say. I have to give it a compute. Okay, so which compute I will give? I already have created one compute for the designer. So that compute then I have to select from here. Okay, so default cluster is the name I have given to that compute. So that I am now selecting here. And one compute I have associated with this pipeline now. So I have associated one compute with a pipeline. I have also given a name to this pipeline. Okay, and now let us use some data from the samples. Okay, so here you will see there are n number of samples available under data sets. Many samples are available there. Okay, even if you try to create your data sample from here by creating data store and data set, okay, those data sets also will be listed here. Okay, so just for the learning purpose, I will be searching for a specific type of sample, movie rating. This is recommendation. So I want to, you know, recommend movies to the users or to the customers. So movie ratings. Okay, this sample let me take here. Okay, if I want to see the output of this sample, okay, I can click here, and here is a graph I will see. So if I see the graph, these are all columns I can see, and this is showing me the quality of the data. Okay, so here it is showing me that this particular sample is actually inclined towards the right side. Okay, so these are all the columns there. 227,472 records are existing here in this sample. Okay, movie ID, rating and timestamp. Movie name is not appearing here. So for that purpose, what I do, I have another sample, IMDb movie titles. So that I drag here and place it here. Okay, now let me check what are all columns here. And here you will see movie name is appearing. So movie ID and movie name, these are the two columns here. Movie ID is also in this data set. This data set has movie ID, okay, and those movie IDs we can, you know, join with the movie IDs here. So here what we will do is we will use join action. Now here, in order to join these two different data sets, I have a ready activity available here. So join, just to see the list of the activities. So many activities available here, data input and output, from where data can be bring in to where data can be synced to, different data transformations. So here in the different data transformations, you can just have a quick look at, you know, normalization of the data, join data. This activity I am looking for. Okay, what are all other actions available here? Split data. So specifically when you have a data and you want to, you know, split it into testing data and training data. Okay, this particular action you can choose. There are other actions also here. You will see Python code can be written, although, you know, very rarely it is needed, but Python code can be written, R language code can be written, and in this pipeline that code also will get executed. Okay, so different recommendation engines are available here. See, recommendation engines are available. So we will go with a train SVD, where SVD stands for singular vector decomposition. This particular algorithm we will use here to do the recommendation. So lots of algorithms are available. Regression algorithms are also available, machine learning algorithms. Okay, so here are all regression algorithms, here are all clustering algorithm, here are all classification algorithm. Okay, so lots of the algorithms are also available here. Okay, so I just choose for join data here. Join data, here it is. Okay, so I drag it. So I am choosing it, and then I drag it with the left key press of the mouse. Okay, and here I have dragged it. Now to this, I have to say intimate to it which column to use to do the joining. I have to intimate to it which column to use the joining. Just hold for a while. Sorry for a break for a while. I was a bit busy with somebody. Yes. Okay. So here I have to mention the column name. Okay, which I want to join from this data set with this data set. So for that purpose, join key columns. From here I can choose the column name. Okay, so now movie ID is a common column and which we can use to establish a relation between these two data sets. So here, okay, now here it is not showing me the list of the columns, because the reason why I don't see the list of the columns here, otherwise ideally it should show me the list of the columns. The reason is, okay, from where it should bring the column list, because for that purpose, you know, I will have to join this output end here and this output end here. Okay, and also what I will do now, I will have to submit it. With the submit, what will happen is that these particular steps will be executed on the cluster that we have created. Okay, so I will be clicking on submit. I have invalid parameter. Okay, now I have to, you know, fill this column value. Okay, and then I will submit it. Okay, now I will have to get the list of the columns here. So when I click here, now see I am getting the list. So movie ID that I will choose here. Then I will click on the save. join column from the right side data set. This is from the left side data set. Same column I will have to join, use to join to the right side data set. It is again movie ID. So movie ID column from left side data set as well as from right side data set, I have to join. Let me check whether I have got some message. Oh, what is this? I don't know. Are these messages for me? Okay, there are a couple of messages sent here. Okay, I don't think these messages for me. So I'm going back. Okay, I want it to match the cases because it is numeric column. Both movie ID and movie ID here, they are numeric columns. Okay, and I want to do the inner join. Okay, otherwise you observe here, different joins are possible. I will do it with the inner join. And with this then, you know, I can now submit it for running on the cluster. If I submit it for running on the cluster, I will come to know whether the joining is happening properly. So now this much pipeline, I click on the submit. Okay, here it is asking me in under which experiment is pipeline to add. As of now, there is no experiment existing. Okay, I will have to mention the name of the, sorry, I will have to ask it to create a new experiment. Okay, so here new experiment train, is the name, recommendation experiment. Compute target is default cluster that we already created earlier. So with this, I am clicking on submit, and now it will take next to 2-3 minutes to run these two steps. Okay, so okay, now so it is running these steps on the cluster that we created earlier. Okay, so I can show you on which cluster it is now running these steps. So it is showing me that these steps are under, you know, processing. So here is the cluster we created, and on this cluster now it has started running those steps. I go back to my pipeline again, okay, recommendation pipeline. Okay, and yes, now within a minute perhaps it will complete its execution. So it is still running. Yes, in the meantime, in case if you have any question on whatever I have covered up till now, let us go ahead, please. Please go ahead for any question on whatever I have covered up till now. Yes, Mr. Rao. Any question, please? Have I got some message? Okay. Is the joining key is a data type sensitive? Yes, obviously joining key is a data type sensitive. So both the joining keys must be of the same data, must be of the same type. Or otherwise we will have to change the format of that key. If in one data set it is integer and in another data set it is numeric string. Okay, so in another data set then we will have to first of all apply one activity to convert it into integer, and that is also possible. So that transformation is also possible, and string we can convert into integer, or integer we can convert it into string. Okay, before we do joining, so that is possible. Yes. Yes, Mr. Sunil. Is your question answered? Okay. Have I got any other question? How can we work with our own data set? Okay, that's a good question. Okay, now here we have to create a data store first. Okay, so when I create click on the data store, it does ask me credential to connect to the data source where my data is existing. Okay, so let me first of all, let me quickly show you how can we do that. Here, new data store I can create. And whenever I create a new data store, okay, it does ask me storage account, where to connect to it, okay, which container to connect to it, okay, authentication details I have to submit here. And thereby, this will just create a channel to connect to the data, connect to the storage account. Okay, after I do this, then I have to create a data set. Okay, and here, create a data set. Okay, from local files or from data store. So I can create a data set. Okay, for the data coming from the URL, for the data existing in my local machine, from the data, okay, I have to bring from the data store. Okay, so if I choose for data store, then it will ask me from which data store it has to bring the data. And then if I fill up rest of the information, okay, it will create the data set for the data existing on the storage. If my data is not existing on the storage, if my data is existing on the local machine, so that is also possible. Where it has gone? Okay. So if I choose from local files, then it allows me to browse to the file in my local machine. If I have some web link from where it can get the data, I have to, you know, mention that web link. So there are n number of options available, okay, from where we can get the data. And what it will do is it will create a data set. It will create a data set. So data set is a data chunk existing in our in this ML service. So it creates a data set well within this service only, and then that data set appears. Once we create the data set, that data set will appear here in the list, in this list. These are all sample data, and our customized data set will appear here. And that data set then I can drag and drop here. So our data set also can be used. Okay, so after joining the data, how data looks, let me check. Okay, it has been executed. So I am clicking here. Now here you observe, this data is coming from one data set and this data is coming from another data set. So movie ID and movie ID. So they are same. Okay, so they are, you know, that way they are joined. And here is the movie name. So joining has happened. Now the next step is there may be some duplicate records. Okay, so those duplicate records we may have to, you know, get rid of. So specifically here, duplicate records are for movie name. Okay, and there may be some duplicate records for same movie name and for some same rating. Okay, I don't bother about timestamp, but in case if there are duplicate records for same rating and same movie name, I don't need those records. So my next step will be, okay, I will be adding here activity to remove duplicate records. So I have done joining. Now I add next activity to remove duplicate records. So that will be available in transformation. Okay, but I don't have to go to the transformation and search for that. I can narrow down search by typing initial characters here. Remove duplicate records. So that I add here. Remove duplicate records. Join this here. And now let us choose. Join this end here. And now let us choose. Okay, which which columns it should use to find the duplicate records. So user ID and movie name, these two columns I can choose here. So I am clicking on edit. User ID, okay, and movie name. Here is the movie name. Okay, these two columns I add here, and wherever it will find these two records duplicated for these two columns, it will remove those records. Okay, so with these selections, retain first and other configurations I am leaving as it is. Okay, now let me submit it. So when I submit it, now it will again ask me which target to use and which experiment this pipeline to run within. Okay, so same experiment I am choosing here, clicking on submit. And now what it will do, it will not run this pipeline again from beginning. Okay, it will simply validate. See, it has quickly executed this step, because this step got executed earlier and now we have not done any change to it. So it has validated it, and now at this step only it will start executing. I got some message. What is the difference in between data set and data store? That is one question. There is an option to create data set from local file, then would it necessary to create data store first? No, in this case, it did not have to create a data store first. Okay, in this case, data set and data store, let me quickly make out the difference in between data set and data store. Data store holds the credentials to connect to data source. All credentials to connect to data source. Okay, at this point of time, it does not know whether we are going to read the data or to write the data or which file of the data store we want to, you know, read. It does not know anything. It's simply holding credentials to connect to the data source. But which file to read the data from, what is the schema of that file, there you have to select for data set. So data set holds which file, what is the path of the file, what is the schema of the data to pull in. Okay, so schema details and file details are held in the data set, and connection details are held in the data store. That is the difference in between these two. Okay, it is still finding out the duplicates record and trying to execute it. So many such transformations are available there. I am just giving you know just one or two examples, but otherwise many such transformations are available there. Okay, it's a long list of the transformations. So I remove this, and here is the list of the transformation. If new column is to be added, if new row is to be added, means from one data set we want to append rows from the another data set, subject to both the data sets have, you know, common schema. Different mathematical operations if are to apply. For example, if two columns are to be added, to ask it to create the third column, so apply mathematical operations. Okay, different cleaning operations if we want to apply. Cleaning operations means in case if values are missing. Okay, if many values are missing from the record, do we want to delete that record? If just few values are missing, okay, from a specific column, whether we can replace that value with the mean of the say value or mode of the value or median of the value. Okay, so different cleaning operations are available. So many such transformations are available. So my pipeline is executed. Okay, I first of all show you data in the join data. Okay, and here in the join data, let us see how many records are there. 224,918. And now let me see how many records are here. 224,914. It means 4 records have been found to be duplicate. 4 records have been found to be duplicate. Okay, so such type of transformations we can apply there. Okay, and then what I want to do is, now I consider I have, you know, my data ready. if I want to clean the data, that activity also I can add here. Huh? So I drag it and place cleansing wala module. Okay, I connect it from here to here. And to the 224,914 records will be submitted to this module. And here it is asking me which record to clean, what columns to clean. Okay, so I choose for all available columns and I just apply, you know, straightforward cleansing mechanism that if data is missing in the column, delete that row. Okay, so here I just apply all columns. Okay, and I'm clicking on save. And what kind of cleansing mode I want to apply, that I can choose from here. And here, remove entire row. See what are all other options available. Replace with mean, replace with median, replace with mode. Okay, I am choosing for remove entire row. So very straightforward cleansing mechanism I am applying. Okay, in real life scenarios, you can just see how many options are available there. Okay, you can choose a suitable one. Okay, and now just let me put to run and let me see how many records it has removed from the data set. Okay. For finding missing values. I have got some question. Let me check. So to say, if our data is in Azure Storage Service, okay, and we want to use that data, we can do that by data store, as data store will have the credentials to those storage account. Yes, you are absolutely correct, Sonal ji. Absolutely correct. Yeah. Okay, its cleansing is still running. Yes, it is done. Now let us see the output. It is still running. It is still showing me the status as running. So let it complete its execution. Okay, so if I click here, none of the record has null values. Okay, every record has all values existing. Okay, so now let me split the data. There are two output endpoints for this activity. One is it will give me the whole data, and another is it can give that data to another kind of a transformation. Okay, so I collect data from here and I use a split activity now. So I have a split activity somewhere here. Split data. So this activity now I choose and drag here. I have got one more question. Which cleaning mode did you use again? I used cleaning mode to delete a whole record for missing values. Okay, but you know, mean, we're replacing missing values with a mean value of the existing values in the column, mode value of existing values in the column, median values of existing values in the column, that is possible. Yes. Now this endpoint, output endpoint of earlier activity, I joined to the input endpoint of split data. Okay, and here you will observe, this will split rows. I am choosing for split rows. Okay, then fraction of rows. Now here see, I am mentioning 0.5. 0.5 means 50% of data it will split for training purpose, and remaining 50% it will split for testing purpose. If I mention here 0.7, so 70% of data it will split for training purpose, and 30% of data it will split for testing purpose. So here what I do, I mention 0.7 because more the data you use for the training purpose, more accurate your, you know, ML model gets created. So I am submitting 70% of data for training purpose and 30% of data for testing purpose. Okay, and other options I don't give here. I close this, and now let me put it to run to see, okay, how it is giving me the data and how it is doing the split. So let us see. Okay, so same experiment I am submitting. And now it will split 70% data into the testing part and 30% data into the training part. Again, I repeat, though it is showing me that these steps it will be executing, no, it is simply doing the validation of those steps. Here also it will do validation, and now this step it will run. Yes, so split data is also executed. Then we will see the how it has splitted the data. So here, see, out of 224,000 records, no, 157,000 records, 70% records are taken into one data set, and remaining 67,000 records are taken into another data set. These 67,000 records we will use for the testing purpose, and these 157,000 records we will use for the training purpose. So here, after doing that, the next activity what we will do is in order to do the prediction of recommendation, okay, we will choose which column to use. We will choose which column to use. And which movie name to recommend to whom. So here I will be adding select columns in data set transformation. So select columns in data set. Here it is. Okay. I need not have to submit all the columns to my recommendation engine. Okay. I will have to submit only those columns which are essential to do the prediction. Okay, so here what I will have to do is select columns in data set. I have this activity I have added here. Okay, now this particular split, okay, I have to join here. So let me set it here. So this particular split I have to join here. Okay, and here then I have to mention the column names. So user ID and movie name, what I will submit here. So edit columns, user ID, okay, and a movie name, because to the user I have to suggest the movie name to recommend him that perhaps he will like this movie. Okay, so this is I have chosen, and yes, only these two columns I have chosen here. Let me again submit the pipeline to run. Okay, and then I will have to select a machine learning algorithm. Then I will have to select machine learning algorithm. So again, I repeat, this data we will use to train the model, And this endpoint we will use to test the model. So whenever we will go for the scoring of the model, we will use this endpoint. As of now, we are training the model, so this endpoint. Yes, it is done. And here if you see the output, only two columns are appearing. So only two columns are appearing. Okay, fine. Let me take it here. Okay, now I have to have the algorithm. So SVD recommender I will be using, singular vector decomposition algorithm I will be using for recommendation purpose. Okay, and here is that algorithm recommendation. Train SVD recommender. So that now I select and I drag it here. Okay, to this algorithm, now I do one thing. Okay, I can, let me delete this link. Okay, and let me connect this link here. Select columns. Okay, I will let you know why I am doing that. Yes, and this link let me connect to here, because now this is training. So training data I have to submit to SVD recommender. So here it will be trained. So I am submitting training data to SVD recommender, and this will be a pipeline for testing. Okay, so whole training data I am submitting to it. Okay, and then I will have to use a scoring. So here is a scoring. So this is I am choosing. And I'm dragging it here. Now, what do you mean by scoring? So scoring means to know whether the algorithm is performing well. Now, in order to know whether algorithm is performing well, what we need to do is we need to submit a testing data to that algorithm. So here, what I have to do, this testing data, okay, I have to submit here. So testing data I have to submit here, okay, and this trained model I have to submit here. So from here it will submit the trained model, and from here it will submit the testing data, and then it will, you know, create a new, it will make the data ready to calculate the performance. Okay, now here what we will do, we will not apply item recommendation, we will apply rating prediction. Okay, item recommended, there are two types of, you know, predictions, collaborative and item. Okay, so I am applying rating prediction here and not the item prediction. So collaborative prediction I am applying here. Okay, and in case if you want to know the difference in between them, better you say explore recommendation concepts. Okay, I am choosing for rating prediction here, and after I have chosen for that, okay, then what I do is I have to put it to run again. So now I am again submitting it. I have got some question, let me check. Can we get recording for this session? I doubt, Monica ji, recording has started. You will have to check with Priyanka. She will make the recording available to you. Okay, Priyanka will decide. Means I don't know, because, you know, I am just a trainer. So
hello, sir. Recording will be published on our YouTube channel, but not immediately after the webinar. It will take some days.
Okay, noted, Monica ji. That recording will be made available to you, but little later. Yes. Huh. Okay. So now let me put it to run. So I'm submitting it. Clicking on submit. Now again, it will take just few minutes. to get ready. And then we will do evaluation. And then we will do evaluation. So this SPD algorithm is known for collaborative filtering. How does it do collaborative filtering? That, you know, there are two users, A and B, and both of them have liked one P1 product. Both of them have liked one P1 product. A has liked P1 product and B also has liked P1 product. Now when A buys P2 product, so it is most likely that perhaps B will also like P2 product, because P1 both liked. Now what about P2? Okay, why it is failed? Let me check. Unexpected number of columns. Okay, let me go to parameter 230. Earlier it did work. I think after I added this, then it is refusing to work. Let me just quickly check what has gone wrong there. Expected 3, but found 6. Number of columns in input data set, training data set of It is correct. Anybody has any suggestion? Let me check. Different number of columns being outputted from train recommender and select columns in the dataset activity. Yes, let me check it. Huh? Okay. Yes, I did one small mistake. Okay. Yes, it has to receive 3 parameters. Okay, I am submitting 6 parameters. I just want to, apply one more, one more transformation here. Okay, and that transformation is for Python code. Okay, I want a Python code to be executed which will choose the 3 columns. Okay, so that one step I simply missed here. Okay, so that Python code I have here. So execute Python script. So thereby I can show you how any script also can be executed. So this script I am copying. Okay, and here then I add that script. So Python language script. Okay, execute a Python script. So here. Here I want to put that script, and this linking, first of all, I will join from here. So I am submitting some all these six columns to Python script, and what this Python script will do, it will choose only specific columns which it has to take ahead. Okay, so that Python script, now let me show you that Python script. And how to write the Python script, that is again important to understand here. Okay, so whenever you are writing any Python script, you have to write that Python script within a specific method. The method name must be Azure main. Okay, that method name must be Azure main. Okay, that method can take two parameters. Okay, but here I don't give any parameter. Okay, and these three columns it is selecting: user ID, movie name, rating, and other columns I don't need to take ahead. Okay, so that's why other columns we are, you know, dropping from here. I got some question perhaps. Let me check. I'm sorry, which value do you choose when you select the score? Due to different number of columns. Huh. Okay, I will come back to this question. Huh? Which values do you... I will come back to this question. Just hold on, please. Yes. So see, I already have told you that this Python script takes two parameters. Those two parameters I have to submit here. If I have, okay, the data for those parameters to come from here, those I can submit here. As of now, I do not have any parameter to come here. Okay, so I am submitting joined data to this Python script. And what this Python script is doing is, it is returning a data frame, okay, of these three columns: user ID, movie name, and a rating. User ID, movie name, and a rating. Okay, now here you try to understand, based on the rating given by one user, okay, whenever user gives a higher rating, definitely that user must have liked that movie. Okay, and so in case if there is a friend A and B, both have seen a movie, okay, and both have given higher rating. Okay, some movie one they have seen and they have given higher rating. Okay, so we need to know the rating factor here. Now when another movie two is seen by friend A, okay, and if he gives a higher rating to movie two, it means that movie is most likely appreciated by second user also. Okay, and that's why movie name and user ID will be the inputs here. Okay, so I will have to make a space available here, so this I take little bit up, and then execute a Python script. Okay, this I join here. Okay, then we will remove the duplicate data, then we will cleansing the data. Okay, so those activities we will do here, and then we will be splitting the data. But what or how many columns here we will be getting? Only three columns. So we will be getting only three columns. Again, I have got some question. Let me check what is that question. Why cannot we use select columns instead of Python script? We can use the select columns also. I fully agree with you. But I am taking this Python to show you how Python script also can be written. But otherwise, we can use a select column also. Okay, but I just want to show you how can we have a Python script there. Because sometimes what happens, you know, you have to do the transformation. While selecting these three columns, you have to do some kind of transformation. You have to execute some of the formulae. So that then, you know, Python script you have to involve. That's why I have had it. Otherwise, there is no reason. I can go with a select column activity also. Now let me submit it. Same experiment and submit. Now here what it will do, the step that has been changed here, okay, it will compile this, it will compile all the steps, okay, and now it will take a little bit more time to bring the data up to this level. In the meantime, if you have some questions, please go ahead. Can you put the script in the chat, please? Yes, I am putting it. Experiment tab also. We are also submitting these steps as we... Oh, okay, that's nice that you are also trying your hands-on. There will be available in the experiment tab, right? Experiment tab also. Okay, you want me to post a script there, right? Okay, I am putting the script. Control C. Control C. Control V. Just one line is important here, this line. All other are simply, you know, comments to describe how can you write Python code. Okay. In the meantime, let me show you experiment also. Yes, it is still executing. I take you to the experiment. Here is the experimentation tag, experiment tag, and that recommendation experiment is appearing here. This is what you want to see. Yes. Okay, I go to the designer recommendation. Okay, now so it is cleaning. Then it will split the data. I got another question. I have created account of Azure 1 month ago, but it says now it is now to upgrade it. See, if it is a free account you have created, the validity of the free account is of the 1 month only. Exactly by end of the 1 month, that account exists there, but it does not allow you to create the resources. That's why it is asking you to upgrade. Perhaps it has it is more than 30 days. So it must be free account, or even if it is a Azure pass, okay, validity of the pass is also of the 1 month only. So it has done the splitting of the data. So if you want to see splitted data, okay, perhaps after completing the running, it will show me the splitted data. So now it has started this. I have got another question. What will be the cost of subscription? Just would like to know, as far as Azure Spectrum is concerned, what is your qualification? Because, you know, in case if you are MCT, subscription cost is different. Okay. So, I get annual subscription in 10,000 rupees. Every year I, you know, renew it. Okay, sorry, how many columns did we select when you join data? Movie ID, while joining, movie ID, only one column I am using to do joining between these two, because that is the only column which is common. That's why only one column I have chosen. Yes. Okay, so still it is running, but now it is on the last step.
For hyperparameter, no? Yes, here it is. So whenever I am choosing the algorithm, okay, here it is asking me to submit number of parameters, number of recommendation algorithm iterations. Okay, these are all hyperparameters. Algorithm to algorithm, hyperparameters headings are different. Okay, so for recommendation, these are couple of hyperparameters. So from here you can submit the hyperparameters. Okay, so after we have done that, I have got another question. Yes, now I have to do evaluation. So in order to do evaluation, I have to choose evaluation activity here. Okay, so name of that activity is evaluate recommender. So maybe that activity is under head recommendation, evaluate recommender. So evaluation means I need to know the performance. What here it has done is the prediction on the testing data it has calculated. Okay, let me show you. So if I go to outputs here, so some kind of prediction it has already done in scored rating. Scored rating is representing the prediction what it has done. Okay, so those predictions then we have to test for. So for that purpose here we have evaluator, but I got one message, let me check. Can we join two different databases in join? Two different databases means what? What kind of operation do you expect? There must be, you know, at least one common column to establish the relationship, and that column we can use for joining. Two different database in join. Data set in join. I did join two different data sets only. I'm not getting your question. Vinayji, can you put your question again? But just note the point that, you know, for joining happens across two different data sets always, at least two different data sets. There is a self join which I am not talking about. Okay, but there must be one common column to do the joining. So I have to take evaluator now. So here I am dragging the evaluator. And to this evaluator, same data set I submit, okay, from here. Okay, that data set I join here. Okay, and output of scoring I join here. And when I put it to run, okay, it will show me root mean square error and what other parameters from where I can come to know about the performance. So this code then I put to run. And now it will show me different parameters, error parameters or performance parameters. From there I come to know the level of the performance of the algorithm. And then we will see those parameters here. what evaluator will have to do is, whatever be the recommendation it will give, okay, that recommendation it will have to match with the testing data. Okay, and it will have to see, okay, whether they are matching. As many recommendations are matching, as good the performance of the algorithm is. Canva cannot process movie name of type string. What I did here, okay, I will come back to you. Okay, just observe here. I can show you, see evaluation results. Here are evaluation results. Root mean square, okay, it is going beyond 1.55. This is really larger value. So error is higher, it means performance is lower. Okay, that is one point. Second point, this R2, this factor, if it's towards 1, gives me idea that performance is good. If it towards 0, gives me idea that performance is not good. So for this model, performance is not good. Okay, so I may have to try with a different hyperparameters. Okay, I have to try with multiple hyperparameters to see for which hyperparameter I can get a better performance. Okay, so I got one more question. This step actually is predicting using trained model and test data. Yes. Okay. So you got some error. Somebody got some error. Okay, it is because if you see my Python script, what are all parameters this Python script is returning? Okay, so there if you observe, oh, these three parameters it is returning. Okay, but why it is giving you the error for the method name? Maybe here what are all columns you are choosing? Split data. Now we will have to check your pipeline why it is throwing the exception. Okay, but otherwise, you know, it seems everything is working fine and my evaluator is also working fine. So everything is working fine here. Okay, we will have to check your somewhere some kind of selection is not proper and that's why it is throwing some error. Okay, but otherwise, see, this pipeline is working and I believe this pipeline is working for others also. For many of us, this pipeline is working. Okay, these are some hyperparameters, those you will have to think of changing. Okay, either this factor or learning rate, you have to change and again try to evaluate it. Okay, there you may get a better performance. But here it is very easy to quickly evaluate your models. Okay, as RMSE is low, this algorithm is not suitable. RMSE is low. RMSE is not low. 1.57 means much higher RMSE. Yes. This algorithm is not suitable. I will not say this algorithm will not suitable. I will say this model is not suitable. How can you test whether this model is, how can you make this model to perform better? So you will have to change the hyperparameters. So just change the hyperparameters and test it again. Okay, maybe you will be getting better performance. So you will have to adjust hyperparameters and you will have to test this model or evaluate this model. So that's all I think I have made for today. Okay, here we have used a designer to create this pipeline. A similar kind of pipeline we can create through notebook also. Okay, and in case if you want to test pipelines across many such models, okay, then you can use automated ML also. Through automated ML, many of your activities are saved and many of your efforts are saved. Can I get your email address? Okay. I'm mentioning my email address. or you can check with Priyanka. Okay, in my profile, she has already mentioned my email address. So just check with Priyanka. She will share it with you. Okay. So that's all for today. Okay, I am really thankful for all of you. Thankful to all of you for joining this session and given me opportunity to, you know, explain something on the recommendation engine. Okay, I hope this interaction will be help. It will help to you as well as to me, and this interaction will be valuable to both the sides. Okay, so over to Priyanka. Priyanka, are you there?
Yes, sir. Thank you so much, sir, for this session, and thank you everyone for joining this session. And for the participation certificate, we are going to mail you a feedback form. Once you fill that feedback form, we will give you a participation certificate. So thanks everyone once again for joining the session. And for the Chandrasekhar sir's mail ID, or you have any doubt you want to clear from him, just visit his LinkedIn profile and drop a message to him, or just forward your query to me. I will forward it to the Chandrasekhar sir. Thank you once again.
Thanks all. Nice talking to all of you. Yes. Thanks, Priyanka, for organizing such a wonderful session, giving me the wonderful opportunity in this session. Thanks, Priyanka. So I'm on mute now.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks, all.
Thank you, sir.